Okay, so this is the same day as when we got those 9 timber rattlesnakes, but we are in a completely different spot going for, is it plethodon jordani?
Plethodon jordani, Desmoganothus imitator, and Desmoganothus ridii.
So, for those of you who don't know, those are species of salamanders. So Zach just flipped both mine and Jacob's lifer pygmy salamander. Really cool. If it'll ever get in focus, hey.
Sorry.
Cute little dude. Well, yeah, there's one lifer out of the way. Cool. Okay, so this area is actually kind of cold. So we're probably not going to see any more snakes today, but we will definitely see more salamanders because this is the perfect habitat for them. Either way, I'll get back to you when we find something else.
I just flipped this little bitty dude. Another pygmy salamander, I think. Yep.
Where's it? Oh, that's a real dark one. I'm gonna have to pick it up.
Yep. All right, another find.
Oh, there he goes. Under that lid. So here we got first red-cheeked salamander of the day that didn't...
God, that's pretty.
Well, technically second, because I just flipped one, but...
This is Jacob's lifer.
Yeah. First in-hand one.
These things are like utter crackheads.
Right, under Zach's hand here is Plethodon jordani, a red-cheeked salamander that is endemic to the eastern side of Tennessee and uttermost western of North Carolina, correct?
Yep, so virtually it's only in the Smoky Mountains.
Yep.
You go to the Blue Ridge Mountains, you're going to get gray cheeks, which are Plethodon moth. Plethodon montanus, Plethodon amplus, and Plethodon something else.
So these guys are only found in this area in the entire world, and it's just amazing. But honestly, if you could compare their behavior, he's calmed down now, but I would compare these to like...
Slimies
and like the twitchiness of like a copperhead, like this crackhead behavior.
Yeah, there's twitchy as a copperhead for sure.
But I would highly recommend anyone that is a fan of amphibians handling them for like periods of time, please wear gloves. Their skin is extremely sensitive, so we don't want to harm them in any way, but we're gonna get this guy back onto his log, get some pictures, and keep on looking at them.
So under this log is red cheek number 2.
Oh my god, that's a big red cheek.
Told you.
Oh.
Watch yourself. Yeah, it looks like he got away. Anyone?
Nope. Nobody home.
All right, let's keep on moving. Okay, Jacob. Ready?
Oh, a little guy.
Little red cheek.
It is. About the size of that green salamander we got. Hold on, lift it up.
And we are wearing gloves up here because these animals are extremely sensitive. And there's a thing actually called Ronavirus rampant in the smoke all the time.
Spotted dusky, dude.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, that is. Odd.
Well.
That's a new species for the area.
Still a salamander.
Yeah. I've just never seen one like that here.
Third red cheek. Under Zach's hand.
Let me tone down.
Oh. Yeah. He gone.
Yeah, he is.
Yeah, he's gone. So Zach just got this Okoe salamander. If you remember from a while back in the spring, me and Jacob actually got one of these in the Smokies, a different location. Now, these guys are a species of dusky, right?
Yep.
Desmonothus Okoe.
But these are probably the coolest desmogs we have here.
Nope. Imitators are. There's another one.
Ooh. Another Okoe?
Yep.
Cool.
See, I'm going to get some cell phone shots of this.
Okay, so I just flipped an imitator salamander. It's Jacob's lifer. And the imitator salamanders here look nothing like red-cheeked salamanders, which is what they're supposed to imitate. So as you can see, it has no red cheeks whatsoever, and a a brownish head. These salamanders, for some whatever reason, don't mimic the red cheeks up here. But a couple miles down the road, they look exactly like red cheeks.
Yep, yet another red cheek salamander. Beautiful.
Please don't, please don't, please, please, please.
Come on, you got this, Jake. Ah! Freaking crackheads, dude. We just want a picture of you. All right, I'm on my way, Zach.
I'm not going this long. They went back under.
Okay.
So I'm going to flip it.
Oh, yeah.
There's one.
There's one.
I don't know where the other's at.
He probably dug up.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
He's dug
There's
up.
So many salamanders here, man. Bet we're making these Midwest guys pretty jealous.
Yep. Rob, we're all looking at you.
As soon as you come to Tennessee, we'll get you on some. So I've lost count of how many salamanders we've seen in this yeah. little spot.
Again, I don't count.
But they are all so cool to find here. Like, amazing. Especially for Jacob, who's never seen these before today.
We'll probably have a Jordani under it.
Okay.
I'm saying a pygmy too.
You saying a pygmy and a Jordani?
Let's see who's here.
Literally nobody's home, okay. Under it.
That one.
Well, I'll be.
Seriously? Well, dang. Well, Zach just flipped a little baby.
Look.
Oh my.
It's the size of our first pygmy.
Holy crap.
Little man.
He's a little baby. Oh my god. Nice flip, Zach.
Thank you.
I'm just gonna make this a timber rattlesnake video.
Yeah, just a little red cheek. Nice, cute little dude. We found a lot of these guys today.
I'd say over 20.
Yeah, easily. So good to find, though. All right, guys, this is what's He's most likely going to be the last salamander of the day.
There he is.
Another
no,
little.
I won't. There's going to be more.
Well, I'm the last one I'm going to film.
All right. Oh, it's a...
But yeah. So, beautiful animals.
Under the sleeve here.
Okay, so I lied. This is probably the last salamander I'm going to film today.
No, it won't. I promise.
Zach, shut up. So, no idea what this is, but we're going to ask Tristan. I'll put a graphic up saying what it is here in a bit. This might be the last one. Probably not, but we'll see.
Okay, so today is actually one of the best herping days of my life. You know, we started with like 9 timbers, 2 copperheads, and then we hit one of my local spots and got, I'd say about 30 red cheek salamanders, 2 pygmy salamanders, a couple of imitators, and what we think are okapis.
3.
Yeah. 3 imitators?
No, 3 pygmies.
Ah, 3 pygmies, yes. And so, now we're gonna pack up and head home, because it's getting a little hot.
I think we did all we can for today, and that's worth it.
I agree.
So, hey, let's get on with it.